Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Last week, we started a series on Excel dashboards. Today, I would like to take a few minutes to introduce the idea of pivot tables. Pivot tables are often used inside of dashboards, so it would be a good idea to go over what is a pivot table and when would be a good time to use a pivot table. So looking at our paper sales data, a few questions arise. The first one is, I have an awful lot of records with the same date. I also have an awful lot of records with the same salesman and the same state where the paper is going. So when looking at this, I would like to sum up all of my data by date, or sum up all of my data by salesperson, or sum up all my data by state. And I would do this by using what is called a pivot table. A pivot table not only sums up numbers, but it can also give you what is called aggregate functions, like averages or counts or mins or maxes of a subset of your data set. So let's see how that can be done. If I click here on J2 and I go up to Insert, Pivot Table, I'm asked a few questions about my pivot table. The first question is selected table or range. So I'm going to click here starting with my column headers and select the entire data set. My next question that I'll be asked is where do I want to put this data set? Because I already selected cell J2, I'm just going to leave it there and say OK. Now, over here to the right, I will see all my pivot table fields. In this case, I would like to see the date and my profit. If I look down here to the bottom right, I will see sum of profit, and I will know that this is the value that is being summed up by date. If I wish to change that to, say, the average or the min that I mentioned earlier, I can click this down arrow and go to View Field Settings. In that screen, you will see down here that there are several different options to summarize my data by. So you can select the one that you want, but for now, we want to leave this as sum. Up here in the custom name, you will see in K2, it's called sum of profit. I can just say total profit or something that's a little more meaningful to the end user and click OK. So now I have my pivot table, and if I would like to, I could highlight this column and go up to Home and just format this as currency since I know it is money. You can also highlight your entire pivot table and center your data if you think that looks better. If I change my data source, I can right click on the pivot table and go to refresh, and my numbers will be recalculated if they're not done so automatically. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. So let's just review doing another pivot table in cell M2. So click on M2, go to Insert, and go to Pivot Table. Select a table or range. I'm going to select the same data that we selected last time, and I want it in M2, so I'm going to say OK. Then I'll go through my columns again. This time I'm going to select Salesman and Profit so that I can see my total profit per salesman during this time. Again, I can highlight my data and center it, and I can highlight this column over here and format that to currency. So now my next pivot table is telling me sales by salesperson. I can change the label up here as well. And finally, in column P, I can insert a third pivot table, same data source, say OK, and this time I can do my total profit by state. Close this window, format my profit numbers, and center my data, and I can see my sales by state. Let me just show you a combination pivot table as well. If I look over here, I will see that I have a few entries for Jim on 7-1. So if I click in cell S2 and go to Insert Pivot Table, I'll select the same date range again, say OK. And this time, let's try it by date and salesman and profit. Close this window, and you will see over here, not only am I totaling by date, but I'm totaling by date and salesman. So it is possible to sum up with more than one criteria. So hopefully that was a good introduction of pivot tables for you today. A pivot table basically sums up a column of data based on the value or values in other columns of data to give you a total picture for either a date, a salesperson, a state, or any kind of combination of that data. We will be using these pivot tables in future lessons on our dashboard. So hopefully you learned a little bit more about this basic element in building dashboards before we move forward. Hopefully you'll watch our video next week and learn some more about Excel dashboards. See you next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.